Hey, posting to the internet, it happens all the time. But what happens if someone posts something that you don't want posted to the internet? Well, that takes us to this week's case. It involves a woman in Los Angeles. And she had a phone that she was returning to Sprint, getting another phone. When she turned the phone in, she forgot that on the phone there were 5,000 pictures. This is one of the joys of smartphones. You have all the stuff on there. Well, you got to remember you have stuff on there. This woman didn't remember that. She had these 5,000 photographs on the phone. She turned it in, and among the photographs that were there were she and a boyfriend engaged in, shall we say, romantic activity. Well, these photographs, which frankly revealed an awful lot of this woman, were then posted to the internet on Facebook by a Sprint employee. Well, needless to say, she and her boyfriend were not happy at all, and brought suit against Sprint. Sprint responded by saying, you know what? We always make an effort to completely wipe clean the memory of all phones that we get when they're turned in. Well, obviously that didn't happen here. And it declined making any further comment, basically saying it was not at fault. Well, clearly it was a Sprint employee who posted it to a Facebook account that was clearly identifiable. Needless to say, this woman's suit is going forward. There's a good, strong probability it will be settled before it goes to trial. But there's an important lesson we learn in this case. And the lesson is, folks, you got to remember, on that smartphone, you may have a lot of information. If you don't want that information to go elsewhere, you need to make sure that phone is completely clean, that the memory is completely swiped before you turn it over to somebody else. And as some people point out, you know, you may not even want to be taking pictures or videos of things that you hope do not wind up on the internet, because today, as we all know, it's a couple of keystrokes and suddenly things are uploaded to the World Wide Web for everybody in this wide world to see. All right, we bring you this case as we bring you cases every week so you understand how we interact with the law and how the law works. I'm David Allen.